हेलो हेलो माइक टेस्ट। जस्ट पुटिंग अ फ्यू कंडीशंस ऑन मोमेंटम एंड एडिंग वन कंडीशन ऑन द सेंटिमेंट एनालिसिस, वी कैन सी दैट वी हैव बिल्ड अ गुड स्क्रीन एंड द रिजल्ट्स आर ऑल्सो प्रिटी प्रॉमिसिंग। द बेस्ट स्टॉक फॉर मी फ्रॉम द स्क्रीन इज सोलर एंड्स फॉर श्योर। Hello financial programmers, I am Ritvik Dashora and I am back with a new video and some new learnings. If you are here to know how to find momentum stocks only for options trading, then yes, you are at the right place. In this video, I am going to use Tradomate, which is my platform, to screen out stocks based on momentum philosophy, and we'll only look for the stocks which have their futures and options contracts as well. A quick disclaimer, guys, through this video, I am not promoting any trading strategy. Please do detailed research before putting your real money into it. This is basically an educational and informative video to teach you how to use Tradomate platform and how to screen out stocks based on the conditions that we put over here. And if you're new to my YouTube channel, guys, on this channel, I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to building some trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, using some highly valuable finance APIs, and creating some great trading strategies, etc., etc. So if this is something of your interest, then you should click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are a lot of things that are in my pipeline which will be uploaded on my YouTube channel, and you can actually check that all the videos that I put on this YouTube channel are completely worth it. So please just click on the red subscribe button right now. So yes, this is the website tradomate.one. The link is in the description section. I'll just directly click on start screening for free, because we want to filter out stocks with momentum philosophy, and we are only focusing on FNO stocks, right? So although most of you guys have already explored Tradomate platform, but a quick 30 to 40 seconds walkthrough for the new guys. Guys, on the left hand side and the right hand side, you will see some words. These are not random words. These are the exact words which are being discussed in news right now. This is basically a list of all the stocks which are in news. If you go to view all news, you'll actually explore all different news of the stocks and what is the sentiment behind this news, what is the impact of this news on their share prices, etc., etc. And the most loved feature of the news segment is this media sentiment in last 24 hours. A lot of traders look for this particular thing, if it is neutral, negative or positive. Cool, I'll come back to screener. Let's start with create your own screen. But if you're interested to explore some of the predefined screens, please scroll down, you'll see some fundamental screens and technical screens. You can start with this if you want. I'll click on create your own screen. So I'll just write, as the title of this video says, how to find momentum stocks for options trading. I'll just write the exact same thing. Find momentum stocks for options trading. Now here, why I'm writing this English sentence over here, guys, this particular search bar is like ChatGPT. You can write normal plain English sentence, or say Hindi sentence, Marathi, Gujarati, any language you speak or are comfortable with. We have built Tradomate AI in a way that we extract the conditions out of the statement that you're putting. Just make sure the conditions are actually for the screening purpose only. Please don't write random things here, otherwise you'll see the error. Okay, find momentum stocks for options trading. I'll just change this to FNO stocks. Right, find momentum stocks for FNO stocks. Cool. Let's run it and let's see what are the conditions. You'll see that it has automatically considered the FNO stocks only. Previously, it was all stocks. Secondly, let's keep all sectors only. I'm interested in NSC exchange. So I'll just keep NSC over here. We'll come to the backtest and the save features later. So these are the conditions. The first one is, in last 21 days, actually 21 trading days, it means last 1 month, because there are around 21, 22 trading days in a month. Cool. So in last 1 month, the price of the stock is more than 10%. And these are the conditions, by the way, guys, are created by Tradomate AI. Please double check it before clicking on the run filters, because you should be completely comfortable with the conditions which are generated by Tradomate AI. So this is the first condition. Second is this one. In last 3 months, the return should be more than 20%. The third condition is last day volume, which is latest day volume, should be greater than the SMA of last 20 days of the volume multiplied by 1.5 times, which is basically a significant spike in volume. And the fourth condition is the SMA, one day SMA for the close with window 50, should be greater than the SMA for window 200, which is basically that following bullish trend. Let's run this these filters, right? Let's see what are the results right now. So just one company, which is Laurus Labs Limited, which also has futures and options, right? And it has shown 0.15% return. The market cap is 45,000. It's a large cap company, right? So these are the conditions that we have created. Now, I might be saying that the conditions which are created, the momentum conditions which are created over here might be brilliant, but I need to understand whether the momentum stocks work well for the F&O segment or not. Right, because that's when I'll have a proper confidence before actually building a trading strategy on it. Right, so I need to do something called backtesting inside Screener itself, and we recently have launched this feature, which is this one, backtest. I'll just quickly save the screen. FP Ritvik Video Momentum Stocks. That's the name of my screen. I'll save it. Cool. For how many candles do I need to should I actually backtest? Let's do it for last 100 candles. It's close to 4 months. 100 trading days is somewhere around 4 months. So I'll just select this and let's click on backtest. So on the below, you can see that there is some movement here because the backtesting is running. We can see that the backtesting is completed. The results are for the last 4 months. The best stock is AB Capital. The best sector is consumer durables. The best weekday is Wednesday. And these are all the stocks on the bubble chart. Now, a quick description of what is this bubble chart, what is this histogram on the right hand side. So basically, I'll just quickly tell you what is backtesting here. What we are doing is, in last 100 days, if we ran the exact same screens, we would have different list of stocks, of course, right? So what was 1 day return and 5 day returns with all the stocks that we have filtered in last 100 days, right? And based on it, we are actually calculating the overall, which is the average return for this particular screen. And these are all the stocks, right? I have selected, say, 1 day here. You can switch it to 5 day as well. You'll see that for 1 day, stocks like HDFC AMC has performed really well. Why? Because there were four number of occurrences here for HDFC AMC. In last 100 days, it followed the momentum philosophy 4 times. And you can see that all the time, the win rate is absolutely 100%. All the time, it actually gave positive returns. And not only positive returns, we have an average return, average 1 day return of 2.18%, right? You'll see some of the stocks like this one, SolarEdge, right? Which has shown 8 number of occurrences here. The average win rate is 75%, still pretty good. Average 1 day return is 1.91%. But on the other side, we have these stocks. For example, AU Bank. There were only 2 occurrences where it has shown some momentum in last 4 months. Average win rate, which is the number of time it actually had positive returns for 1 day, was 0%. And the average 1 day return was -1.08%. So basically, for AU Bank, mostly the philosophy that we build for momentum stocks doesn't work really well if you're talking about 1 day return. And that's how we have calculated the overall. The overall win rate is 61.74% for the screen, with the average 1 day return of the screen is 0.64%. On the right hand side, you'll see the histogram, which is basically all these returns with respect to the number of frequencies. You'll see that there are many green bars here as compared to the red bars, which is a good thing. The average 1 day return, mean return is 0.64%. I would like a screen where the number of green bars are as much as possible, and the number of red bars should be as low as possible, and the height of the number of red bars should also be very small. Cool. No worries. We'll come back to the filters. We'll actually improve it. But let's first see what are the stocks and how does the calendar return look like, right? So this is basically on the deep dive here. I'll keep selected 1 day only. We can do it 5 day as well. But for 1 day, these are the calendar returns, right? The green squares are basically the days where we had positive returns. The red squares are the days where we had negative returns. And this is basically the entire list of all the stocks. I can actually sort it with the number of times it occurred in the screen. SolarEdge has the highest number of occurrence, which is 8 times it has shown some momentum in last 4 months. And the 1 day return, sorry, 1 day win rate was 75%. 5 day win rate was absolutely 100%, which is a good thing. So basically, whenever momentum happens in SolarEdge, for one week for 5 days, the possibility of it being a positive return is pretty high if you consider the analysis that we did. And not only that, the 5 day average return was close to 8%. This is very interesting. Cool. But yeah, I need to work, if I just scroll down till the end, I need to work on this thing to increase the win rate of the entire screen, right? So I'll come back to our philosophy, which is these are the conditions. I'll stick to 1 month return, but let's change this one from last 63 days to just 1 day, because I am interested to see momentum in last 1 day as well. And let's do it, say 2% or say 1%, right? So in last 1 day, the price has given more than 1% return. Basically in last 1 month, 10%, last 1 day, 1%. I think it's a good definition of a momentum. Then I think volume is absolutely fine. I'll keep it like this only. The SMA is also pretty good. That's how we are considering the bullish trend. I would like to add one more thing here, because at Tradomate, we are not only focusing on the technical analysis, we can actually screen stocks based on fundamental analysis as well. You can just write revenue growth of more than 10%, all these types of things as well. But another great feature, which is actually not available anywhere, and I highly recommend you guys to use it a lot, which is sentiment analysis. So I'll be building one condition on the sentiments of the stocks. So I'll just write stocks with positive sentiment in last 5 days, right? So what it does is it extracts all the news information for the last 5 days for all the stocks, and it considers that the sentiment of the news is positive or not. We have more filters like category, source, etc. You can explore these things yourself. So let's run this these filters. But before that, let's just select all the sectors over here. I'll click on run filter. We'll see that there's no company right now which has matched this thing. But I'm more interested to do backtesting, because historically there would be some companies which would have been filtered out. And I'm actually interested whenever a new company comes, maybe like tomorrow or day after tomorrow, that's also fine. So it's absolutely fine if I'm not seeing any company today. But let's do backtesting. I'll click on start backtesting again. Cool. All the results are backtested for last 4 months. The best stock is the same, which is AB Capital, Consumer Durables and Wednesday. Most of the things are same only. But there are some more companies over here. Solar Ends is still here. The number of occurrences of Solar Ends has gone down because we have added the news condition as well. It looks very interesting. But you'll see that Solar Ends has, I think, 75% win rate for 1 day in the last conditions. But you'll see that it's 100% right now. If you do 5 days, it's hiding somewhere here only. Yeah, it still has the 100% win rate, number of occurrences 4. But a very interesting fact here is that the overall win rate has gone up a bit, right? Not significantly, but I'm just telling you how we can actually keep on playing with different conditions in a way that we would like our overall win rate to be as high as possible, right? Now, this bubble chart is basically on win rate and average return, and the size of the bubble represents the number of occurrences. So if there is a very huge bubble on the top right side, then that's the best thing, because the number of occurrences are also very high, and the win rate, 1 day win rate and or 5 day win rate and average returns are also pretty high, right? So for example, this one is BEL, 80% win rate, number of occurrences is pretty high. We talked about the Solar Ends already. Let's go back to the deep dive section. You'll see many more green squares here. Which is a good thing. And again, you can do some screening from here to see what are all the different stocks that you should be considering. Actually, if I just go back here, if I just remove one thing, one sector, which is say banks, then let's see what are the results. I'm actually interested doing it. It's not scripted, by the way, guys. I was just exploring the results and I thought that momentum doesn't work that well in the banking sector. So I'm just interested to remove that one sector and let's see what are the results. You'll see some movement here and there. Our tech team has built a very intuitive analysis platform. We'll see a lot of movement here. Okay, it's done. The overall win rate has gone up by a lot now. It's more than 70%, right? We can see a lot of stocks on the rightmost side, like for example, BEL, MCX, Solar Ends, and all these stocks are still here. There are very few stocks on the leftmost side. So this is how you should be exploring the platform. This is how you should be using Tradomate.one. And by just putting a few conditions on momentum and adding one condition on the sentiment analysis, we can see that we have built a good screen and the results are also pretty promising. the best stock for me from this screen is Solar Ends for sure. Okay guys, that's it. I want you guys to check out and test different types of filters at Tradomate. Please let me know in the comment section if you want me to explore any specific types of conditions, or if you have any questions struggling in any particular thing. You can see through my past videos that I reply to all the comments within 48 hours. Also, if you are still watching this video, guys, you owe me 2 clicks, please. One is, please click on the like button. It really helps with the algorithm. It's free of cost for you, but it matters a lot to the YouTubers like me. Second is, I think you've already done it, but again, I'm reminding you, please click on the red button down below, the subscribe button, and hit on the bell icon. I want to cross 100k subscribers as soon as possible, and your one click will help me reach there. Regarding the platform, if you have any feedback, feel free to reach out to me at fpritvik@gmail.com. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Over there, you'll see this entire playlist on Tradomate, and over there, you'll see how to use the rule-based logic creator at Tradomate.1 to build some great trading strategies. But yes, keep learning, keep financial programming, and I'll see you very, very soon in the next video, next Saturday, 6 p.m. Until then, peace.